welcome you inside Fifth Third Arena in Cincinnati, Ohio, the final game of the American Athletic Conference regular season. And it's a game with a lot of meaning for the Bearcats as they need to pick up their 20th win to keep their tournament hopes alive. It's the Bearcats playing host to the Owls of Temple University. As we look at the American Athletic Conference standings, they are right up at the top of it, but a lot still to come when it comes to the Athletic Conference tournament that's next week. Plus, we've got the starting lineups here. Temple starting, of course, J.P. Mormon, Nate Pierre-Louise, Damian Moore, Quinton Rose, the all-time leading scorer in the history of Temple University. All seniors, including the walk-on John Coase for Cincinnati. Jarron Cumberland, who missed the last game with a heel injury, is in the starting lineup for Cincinnati. Alex DiMario alongside Tim Doyle, glad to have you with us. And Timmy, this game, a ton of meaning for Cincinnati. It's obviously senior night. It's a game that obviously means something to them in the standings, but it's also, you got these two first-year coaches doing battle.
Aaron McKee knows that he's got to dictate tempo in this game. And on the flip side, John Brannan's team comes into this game leading the American Athletic Conference in scoring. So they want to push pace Cincinnati. Temple wants to slow you down. The first meeting was a barn burner. It was a one-point game with 3 minutes left. Temple's playing with free money. This means everything to Cincinnati. Alex Del Barrio, it's simple. Something's got to give.
Cincinnati at 19-10, 12-5 in the American Athletic Conference. Temple at 14-16. They're losers of four straight games. Cincinnati in the red, Temple in the black. We are underway in front of what was expected to be a sellout crowd here at Fifth Third Arena. Timmy, what do you want to see here in the first few minutes from both of these players?
I really want to see how Jarron Cumberland is moving out there. Talk to him before the game. And, you know, wouldn't really dive into with me if he is at full strength or not. Turnover by Cincinnati, but missed last game. He's not at 100%. Frankly, he hasn't been at 100% all year. Last year, the reigning player of the year in the American Athletic Conference. And I'm sure he wants to have a special night on his senior night.
Nate Pierre-Louis, J.P. Mormon, and this is Quinton Rose. Up at the top to Damian Moore. The second. Temple has had a rough go of it this year under new head coach Aaron McKee. He'd been on the staff of Fran Dunphy over the last 5 years. Steal in transition here. Scott to the rim and has it stripped away. They say it's off of him, out of play. Fans don't like the call.
This is going to be the challenge of Temple. Scoring in the half court, active hands on both ends of the floor. Two possessions for Cincinnati, two turnovers.
And we're talking about Coach McKee, of course, an assistant with the Sixers. Of course, he's a Philly guy, played his high school ball in Philly. And he wants his team to play Philly tough. We talk about how his team's having grit. And he's sixth man of the year. Cincinnati with a basketball here. And there's Cumberland. And has dealt with kind of some nagging injuries throughout the year, including his heel, which kept him out of the last game against South Florida. Scott launches from long range, misses way off. Now here comes Temple.
I don't think they're going to be sending the first three Cincinnati possessions to Springfield, Massachusetts. Two turnovers and then an air ball off the glass.
There's Rose on the drive. Can't finish on the first effort. Tried for the tip, couldn't get it to go. Temple with the offensive rebound will reset. Trying to get an entry pass inside to Moore. And coming up with a foul is Scott.
The last two games for the Temple Owls, they have scored 109 combined points. So they're really struggling from an offensive standpoint. Last out against Tulsa, lost 61-51. Only shot 29% from the field. Only shot 23% from three. I think it's going to be imperative today that they make 10 three-pointers, and that first loss to Cincinnati, 89-82, they made nine in that game, and that's why it was so close going down the wire.
The vote coming out of the game, official signaling that he's got blood on his uniform or something. Saying he had the wrong color t-shirt is what we're being told. He had to come out. There's a floater. More misses, and here comes Cincinnati. Still no score here after 2 minutes gone by. all the seniors in the starting lineup here for Cincinnati. Nice little skip pass over to the corner. Three-point attempt off the mark. Both these teams struggling with their offense right now, Timmy.
That's a really good look by Cumberland, though, to find the open shooter in the corner. Great catch down low.
Fast break bucket there from Damian Moore. And Temple, not a team that's going to light it up offensively. There's a team, they're a team that relies on their defense. One of the top teams in the country defensively, 38th nationally in field goal percentage defense. Cumberland, his cousin Javen. Scott trying to get it to Jarron, and he turns it over. Not in the position he wanted to. 17-12 to go here in the first.
Watch this catch, and that's most impressive. Most big fellas can't handle that. Great job by Moore, who's had some moments this year. Last out against Tulsa in 21 minutes, had 9 points. He's been in and out of the lineup for Aaron McKee as he is trying to find answers for scoring on the offensive end.
Right now, Temple with the lead in the basketball. Dump it down low, and there's a takeaway from Mamadou Diarra. The dues from the crowd here in Cincinnati as Cumberland's off to the bucket. He draws the foul.
And that's Jarron Cumberland's game. Yeah, he wants to get into the lane. He wants contact. He likes that physicality. But he's just not playing with that same burst. He doesn't have that explosion, and you can kind of see him walking right now. He is gutting it out. I asked him before the game, more nervous for senior night or more excited? He just smiled and said, more excited.
So Cumberland here to the free throw line. 75% free throw shooter on the year, connects on the first. Cincinnati finally on the scoreboard. Cincinnati 12-5 in the American Athletic Conference. They're still in contention for first place here in the final game of the regular season. We're knotted up at 2. A little pressure here from Cincinnati. Temple, nice job of breaking the press. This is Pierre Louis. Nate Pierre Louis. Two brothers on the Temple squad. His brother Josh also on the team, a freshman. Pierre-Louis, fall-away jumper is short. Offensive rebound underneath, and the putback is good. And Temple already with their second field goal.
Good job by Moorman. You got to have kind of a plethora of moves down there and flippers and great touch, as it hasn't been pretty for Temple, but you look up, you're up 2. And so far, the pace of this game, Alex, this is what they want to play. They want to keep this game in the 60s.
Cumberland for 3 from the outside, trying to come in for the offensive rebound was Diarra, couldn't get there. And this is the type of game Temple wants to play, like you said, Timmy. And we talked with head coach Aaron McKee before the game. He's like, almost the slower that we keep it, the better our chances are. As Rose, the all-time leading scorer in the history of the conference, buries one there. And it's a 7-2 lead here for the Owls.
And what's important was there was a lot of emotion. That senior night, we had a great national anthem. And Temple has come out here and kind of sucked the air out of that building.
Coach McKee wanted to make as well. It's like, if we can take the crowd out of this one early, we can keep the emotions down. There's another miss. Dump it underneath. Beautiful feed. And Damian Moore finishes there for the Owls. And it's a 9-2 lead here for Temple. Cumberland up high. This is Scott, right wing for 3. Still no. Still without a field goal here for Cincinnati. 15:08 to play here in the first half.
If you're Cincinnati, you've got to find this guy right here. We touched upon it, but when you say it, you got to digest it too. The best score in the history of this conference, Quinton Rose. And on the flip side, Damian Moore's had some really nice catches down low and finishes. Cincinnati's looking for answers. They're having a tough time really executing any offense. They're throwing the ball all over the place. And what it appears to me, Alex, is when they go through a rut, I can see the guys all look to Jarron Cumberland. They're like, all right, now it's your time to go. But he's not at full strength, and he's trying to gut this out right now. They're going to have to find other ways for other guys to step up and score.
And we welcome you inside Fifth Third Arena. You're watching Bracket Week presented by Kubota. As the Temple Owls out to a 9-2 lead on the Cincinnati Bearcats on the final game of the American Athletic Conference regular season. Cincinnati, their tournament hopes hanging in the balance as they are looking for their 20th win of the year. As we take a look at the American Athletic Conference standing, Cincinnati still with a chance to finish up at the top of the conference. They know they'll have a bye when it comes to the first round of the American Athletic Conference tournament coming up next week. But their tournament hopes are hanging in the balance. Alex DelBarrio alongside Tim Doyle, glad to have you with us here in Cincinnati. And so far, Temple is keeping Cincinnati away from the scoreboard. The only 2 points they have is from the free throw line.
Well, it's an emotional night here in Cincinnati. You got senior night, you got a pressure-packed game, you got a must-win game for John Brennan here in his second year. And he knows how important this game is. On the flip side, Aaron McKee played high school in Philadelphia, played professional ball in Philadelphia. Oh, and by the way, he went to Temple and now is the head coach there. They want to dictate pace in this game. And so far they have. Cincinnati 0-5 from the field, 3 turnovers, no offensive rhythm for the Bearcats.
Right now, Temple likes the way this game is being played. Coach McKee talked about it to us just before the game about trying to keep the crowd out of this one. And they were loud for this senior night. They were all here early to kind of reward this Cincinnati team, especially these seniors who have done such a great job over their 4 years here in the Queen City. This is Rose throwing it up underneath, kind of a poor angle shot, and it goes off of the fingertips of Jake Forrester.
What's happening right now to the Bearcats is when they're struggling offensively, they're looking to their leader, and right now Jarron Cumberland is not at 100%. Missed last out against USF, a game they had to make a dramatic comeback and win Cincinnati. Every game so important, every possession so important. Can Cumberland gut this out on his senior night in a big spot for his squad?
Scott looking to get it inside to Vogt, and we're going to whistle, and it's going to be a foul sending it the other way.
Yeah, that is Cumberland there with the screen. And just watching him, talking to him before the game, he's not at 100%. And he's been bothered all season, and most recently by a foot injury. But he is out there, and you could just tell he doesn't have the same burst. Last year, the conference player of the year, all of his numbers are down with the exception of assists because his role has changed. Now playing primarily point guard, one of the best passers in this conference.
It's just something he hadn't done up to this point. And we get beautiful block there. Two-handed block from Vogt on the drive to the bucket from Nate Pierre-Louis.
If you're just joining us, Vogt had to go to the locker room because he had on the wrong undergarment. Not the wrong jersey, the wrong undergarment of his jersey. Checks back in a big way. At least he had the right jersey on. That's important.
Air ball from the corner in Cincinnati with the rebound. They need to find a bucket here in a big way.
Vogt's working hard down low.
All right, let's take a look at the starting lineups tonight. Brought to you by Kubota. As we look at the players on the floor right now, Forrester, the sophomore, they like what he can do. Nate Pierre-Louis doesn't shoot it well, but can score in bunches for them. And then, of course, Jarron Cumberland on the other side for Cincinnati. He's such a fantastic player for them all year long. Reigning player of the year, as we mentioned. Those are, the players on the floor right now, presented by Kubota. This is Cumberland, just mentioned, buries one. And finally, at the 13:45 mark here in the first half, Cincinnati gets a field goal. Now the crowd starting to slowly get into it here. Rose trying to fight his way through. The double comes. Now they get it to the corner. This is Moore for three, and he rattles one home.
Yeah, that's going to be the key. In the first matchup, a very competitive game, Temple made 9 threes. They make less than 7 a game. I think they have to make on the road 10, maybe 11, if they're going to walk away with an upset win.
This is Williams up high. Good drive and good dump ball. Scott underneath, can't finish under the basket, ball tapped around, and Alane Moore the second has it now for Temple. goes. Double was just waiting for him. They'll step off of him. He'll go for the follow-away here and miss. Kick it outside. Wide open again. Alonnay Moore for three, and he hits another one from downtown. 15-5. Temple with a double-digit lead here on senior night in Cincinnati.
Of all the guys on Temple, Alonnay Moore is the last guy you want to leave open. 66% of his made field goals in his career have been threes.
Here's Cumberland with the dump off. Kick it out left wing. Good corner from Adams Woods. Misses. Vogt with a rebound.
I would go right back to Vogt down low. You got to get something else going offensively.
And we got a foul. For those of you watching on CBSSports.com, our streaming coverage will conclude after the commercial break, but we'll continue on CBS Sports Network. You can find us by going to CBSSportsNetwork.com/channelfinder. Lead for the Temple Owls in what is a very important game for the Cincinnati Bearcats if they want to keep their at-large tournament berth alive. As we welcome you courtside, Alex Sobario alongside Tim Doyle. And Timmy, I think that the emotions of senior night might have gotten the better of Cincinnati here early on, because they got one field goal in this game, and right now Temple playing the way they want to.
Yeah, well, Cincinnati is playing very poorly, and Jarron Cumberland did not play last game. And anytime you add back in a player, your best player, that's going to disrupt some rhythm. He's not at 100%. He is trying to gut it out. As for Temple, they're playing with house money. They've lost four straight, and they can play the role of spoiler. So far, they have.
And right now, Jerry Palm has Cincinnati as the last team out when it comes to the NCAA tournament. So they know they're going to be having a bye next week in the American Athletic Conference tournament, but they need to play well in that tournament, but they can't go in coming off of a bad loss to the Temple Owl team.
Yeah, everything you just said equals for John Brennan's team, must win.
John Brennan, obviously tough for him, playing with a heavy heart after losing his father 1 week ago today. Father with a long battle with ALS and dementia. The father that worshiped Oscar Robertson was always at both his games and his brother Grant's games. His brother Grant stepped down over at Walton Verona High not too long ago. Right now, trying to coach his team to an important 20th win as we get another offensive foul the other way, sending it back to Temple.
You're going to get Vogt over the back here, and out of a timeout, trying to get Keith Williams going. I think John Brandon's just looking for any answers. Williams' last out was outstanding, and a come from behind win against USF. He had a career high 30 points. Cincinnati's looking for answers on the offensive end.
And right now they got a two-on-one working to Rose as he drives it in. Vogt able to get his hands in there and deflect it. And now here come the Bearcats.
Temple is really working. Watch Vogt down low. They've really done a nice job pushing him out of the spot where he wants to catch it.
Whistle on the other end, and another foul called against Cincinnati.
Yeah, good call here. Now watch how Vogt uses his left arm to clear out the defender. You got Bill Jacobson, one of the best referees in the Midwest, right on top of it. Watch his left arm, right there. You can't dislodge your defender like that. Bill Jacobson right on the call. I think an easy one. Fans don't like it. They're frustrated as their team only has 5 points first 8-plus minutes of this game.
So Vogt, the 7-footer, will head to the bench. The junior transfer who came with Coach Brandon from Northern Kentucky. Too far down the road. It's 15 miles down the road.
You get your GPS out. You didn't get it out, and that's why we were late for the game, but that's okay.
This is Alonnay Moore up at the top. Nice crossover there, and fans wanted a carry. Just getting it off in time. Over the right wing is Monty Scott. The ball goes out of play and back to Cincinnati.
Don't read lips if you're at home, okay? Fans are frustrated here. If I'm Cincinnati, I think we got to get something where Keith Williams is going to the basket. He's right up here. Get him the rock.
Stop. Here's Scott up top. Good ball fake as he drives to the bucket. Dump off underneath. And they get a lay-in there from Amadou Diarra. The redshirt sophomore from Mali. He had a season-high 8 points in their last game on Tuesday at South Florida. Pierre Louis kicking out to Moore. He's got a couple of threes here in this first half. To Pierre Louis. Scott on the drive in. We get a whistle, no shot, says the official.
This might have been Cincinnati's best possession of the game. It's a dribble penetration. Diarra was not known as a scorer, but played excellent, excellent last out. With no Cumberland in the lineup, he really stepped up. 8 points, 7 rebounds, and that come from behind win against USF. That was a game they were down 13 with 13 minutes left. A 36-11 run to end the game. Since he only had 2 players in double figures, but walked away with a W.
Temple now in the bonus after Cincinnati picked up their 16th foul just a moment ago.
And if you're Quentin Rose, you got to recognize that and be aggressive, attack the rim.
Here's Rose, top of the key. Not heeding your advice there, Timmy. Adams Woods to the rim, and that's rejected from behind. And it'll stay with Cincinnati.
Aaron McKee is known as a mild-mannered, stoic player. And he has been fired up on the sidelines. He got an electric environment here. His team's going through a bit of a rut. They've lost 4 straight games. They've only scored 109 points over the last 2 games. But he's got them fired up, and they are playing extremely tough right now on the road.
They're only losing their last 4, but they haven't beat Cincinnati in a while, losing 6 straight to the Bearcats. Fallaway jumper there, off the mark. And here comes Rose for Temple.
If you're Rose, you just got to recognize you're in the bonus. So you got to get your team going towards the basket.
Spin move on the baseline there from Damian Moore, and comes back the other way. Foul called against Moore.
Fans of Cincinnati here excited. They feel like they finally got a call.
to 7, Temple on top. Field goal still not coming, though, for the Bearcats. Cumberland drawing a foul there. That's 5 team fouls now on Temple.
If I'm Jarron Cumberland, how do you adjust when you can't go by somebody? I think once in a while you got to throw him in the post, because he doesn't have that same burst. You could tell he was trying to push off there, and he's just trying to gut this one out. He buried a 3 earlier in this game. But if I'm John Brandon, I'm trying to move around my best player to get him in position to succeed. I think it's almost too hard for him to score all the way out front.
Cincinnati working the ball inside again. It's time to Scott. Jump hook, it's good. Trevon Scott. The redshirt senior from Townsend, Georgia, got a great ovation in his senior night presentation. I mean, it was loud. Here's Pierre Louis, the younger one. Josh, the freshman out of New Jersey, he misses. Now here come the Bearcats. Hands one of the foul on that reach in, and we get a whistle, and now they're going to get one here on Josh Pierre-Louis.
You see Trevon Scott. Now, he used to be Trey Scott, but his mother said, I want him to be called by his birth name, Trevon. So, Trevon, mom's here. She's going to get love. We're going to call you Trevon, all right? You can call him whatever. He's been awesome the last 7 games. He's had 20 points or more in 4 of the last 7 games, and he's really playing his best basketball of his career.
Get it down low. Bucket there. Diarra. You can hear the doos from the crowd here in Cincinnati. Mamadou Diarra. 6-0 run here for Cincinnati. They pulled it within 4. Deflection and a takeaway. Trevon Scott finding the trailer Diarra. Cumberland thought about it for a second. Take it outside. This is Harvey from long range. No. This crowd wants to explode on a made three right now. Dump it into Rose. Nice bounce pass underneath. And a foul going up. 17-11. Temple gets the and one attempt here on the other side.
Great block, but refs say a little too late. Fans don't like the call. They're fired up. Must win game. Get back for Cincinnati.
College basketball on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Kubota. Together we do more. By the Army National Guard. Learn more at NationalGuard.com. And by AT&T.
Taking a look back at the history and career of Aaron McKee, the player, formerly at Temple, and of course the Philadelphia 76ers, might as well be Mr. Philadelphia, taking over now in his first season as the head coach after several seasons as an assistant. You take a look, since 1952, only five men have been a head coach at Temple. He played under John Chaney, coached under Fran Dunphy, and now he's the head coach.
And he is been a terrific hire and has brought great energy and excitement to the Philadelphia area. His team has come out and they have played tough, they've played physical. I think more importantly, they buried some shots. That's what he told us before the game. He goes, we're gonna have to make some shots in this one. They made 9 threes in the first matchup, a very competitive game in Philadelphia, one that was a 1-point game with 3 minutes left against the Cincinnati team. So far in this game, Alex, 3 threes, and they've really been the more physical team on the road.
Yeah, they're 3 of 6 from downtown. He told us before the game, he's not really a 3-point shooting team. That's not really what we do. But when they take them, they've been open. Alani Moore's got a couple of those. It's helped them get out in front here in the first half. What kind of adjustments does Cincinnati need to be making offensively right now to deal with this Temple defense?
It's a great question. I don't think John Brandon has the answers to that.
On the drive in, another miss. This time from Harvey, and now Temple took the crowd out of it early. Now they have the crowd antagonized. Here's Rose. Can't finish the 18-footer.
You know, Temple has been in the bonus now for 3 minutes, and they've really had minimal drives going towards the basket.
Cumberland with the spin in the lane. Beautiful move! And that'll get the crowd into it. Offensive foul the other way.
And you can see Jarron Cumberland. He's out there with his basketball guile trying to gut it through. It's senior night. It's last night. Potentially he could be on this floor. He buried a three earlier. And you could see his teammates. He didn't play last game.
Yeah.
And now that he's back out there, they're like, all right, buddy, we need you to take over. And he's going to have to put this team on his back and will his team. But you asked me before, what is John Brandon need to do? I think he's looking for those answers. He's tried a lot of different things to check out his mother in the stands. What an outstanding senior night ceremony for the crowd, and what a great crowd it is here in Cincinnati.
They've been on their feet since the very beginning. We got here an hour before the game, the seats were filled. Right now, they're Bearcats trailing by 4 to a Temple team looking to play as much of a spoiler as they can. Here's a Rose. Pass, try to dump it off to Parks underneath, and can't get it to him. Parks, the redshirt freshman from North Royalton, Ohio. Turnovers even at 5 apiece. Cumberland with 10 on the shot clock. He's gonna take the long one. Too strong. Rebound to Rose.
And you're Aaron McKee right now, you got to get Quentin Rose going to the basket if there's help. He has to find teammates. He's got to try to make something happen. Temple's really been in a drought.
Rose on the take. Pierre-Louis. Now Mormon. And he's called for the walk.
Mamadou Diarra is going to get no stat for that. Not a block shot, not a steal, but he caused that turnover. Great rotation on defense. He's giving them some really good minutes. Defensively, he's had a couple buckets off the bench.
Hasn't playing all that long. 6'9" forward out of Mali. And had 8 points that last game against South Florida. He's really just started to play better here as of late. Here on the screen, they were trying to little screen and roll action. They weren't looking for him, but he was open. Long pass ahead, deflected out of play. And it'll stay with Temple.
You can see Cumberland got stuck in no man's land. And bad turnover on the opposite end. Quentin Rose buries the jump shot and stops the bleeding. This was a 15-5 Temple lead. It was all Cincinnati, and then Rose with a big bucket.
Rose has five. There's another takeaway. Temple gets it to Rose in transition. To the rim, goes for the rim rocker. Couldn't get it to fall. But Temple looking for those buckets in transition. Right now, Temple playing the way they want to. We'll step aside here. 19-13. Temple on top. But a defensive battle here in Cincinnati. And now it's time for Hometown Heroes presented by Army National Guard. See the Cincinnati Bearcats participating in a little community service over at Nassau Park. It was back in August of last year. And coming up on AT&T at the half, back at the studio, they'll get you caught up on all the highlights from college basketball tonight. It's been a wild day in all of college basketball. We'll have highlights and stats from our game, Brent Stover, Wally Zerbiak, John Rosti, Seth Davis, and Jerry Palm, all in studios. As we look at the bracket, if the season ended today, Tulsa, the number one seed in the American, Temple would take on South Florida, a game that we had on our air last week. Game that USF won, and Cincinnati, you can see, as the three seed, would take on the winner of SMU ECU again if that tournament started today.
This is a important spot. Nobody wanted to hear that this is a must-win game. This is a must-win game for Cincinnati. Jerry Palm knows that. America knows that. Everybody in Cincinnati knows that. They get off to a bit of a rough start, and you got to wonder. Yes, Temple's up 7 with a chance to go up 8. Could they be up 14? Could they be up 15? I think they could. Cincinnati's really had a tough time getting anything going. You just wonder, have they taken full advantage of that on the road? I think they're leaving the door open for the home team and a crowd that's been excited from the jump ball.
Cincinnati this year used to scoring a lot. They're 12-2 when they score 72 or more. Right now, just 13 points here in this first half.
2-3 zone, first look at that. Good ball reversal.
Shot in the corner for three. There's Vogt with the offensive rebound. He's fouled from behind, and Vogt will head to the free throw line.
Vogt did a good job of keeping the ball high enough to get fouled, but he's got to get up a little bit faster than that. Rose doesn't like the call.
Vogt on the season, just a 58% free throw shooter. This is on the first. Fans, make sure to tune in to the 2020 Reese's College All-Star Game presented by Walmart. That's April 3rd, live at 3:30 p.m. Eastern, right here on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. This can cut it to 7. Vogt misses. Been just one of those halves for the Cincinnati Bearcats. Pierre-Louis. Trying to kick it out. He does. Three-point attempt. Devondre Perry, he misses. And the rebound taken by Trevon Scott. Cumberland on the take, and we get a hand check called against Pierre-Louis.
You got to do a better job with your tempo, not reaching here. Now, Cumberland's having a tough time getting by people, and that's just, in my eyes, extreme lazy defense, because now you give a player who has had a tough time getting going a chance to get to the free throw line and build some confidence.
Substitution here as Diarra comes back in for Vogt. Cumberland gets the first to go. It's tomorrow starting at noon Eastern. It's the Patriot League semifinals. Find out which teams will advance to the championship game only on CBS Sports Network. It's at Boston U. My alma mater taking on Bucknell. Colgate taking on Lafayette. Patriot
Colgate's,
League action.
They're going to be a tough out in the tournament. Look at Cincinnati here. They might extend pressure, try to get some offense from their defense.
And the pressure in the backcourt. For most of the first half, the Temple's did a nice job of breaking it. And they do again. Here's a pass underneath. Beautiful movement. Again, it's a Perry for the lay-in. Did not play in the last game against Cincinnati. They're suffering a toe injury that kept them out for several games. Here's Scott. The one-handed jumper misses off of the window. 2:20 to go here, first half. Moore trying to find some room. And nearly a takeaway, able to re-get. Goes for the reverse, that's partially blocked. Has to get it back. Five on the shot clock, ball still loose on the baseline. Cumberland's got his hands in there. And the shot clock expires. One official says shot clock violation, and that's exactly what it is.
I used to love the Royal Rumble when I was young. And you got a Royal Rumble these guys going after. I mean, where's Rowdy Piper? Get him out there right now. Guys are diving all over the place. Love the energy, love the effort. And I'm not sure if Temple's missing their window right now to have a double-digit lead. This becomes a very important last minute 50 if you're Cincinnati, because this door is open to still win this game, a game that is oh so important.
There have been no field goals for Cincinnati in nearly 4.5 minutes until right there, as Cumberland able to stop the bleeding a bit. Makes this a 6-point game. This is Perry. Three-point attempt from the wing. Buries it. Devondre Perry. It's 40% from out there.
And he buried four threes against Miami this year, a game that he had 18 points. That was a big shot because you could feel momentum starting to swing back to Cincinnati. Temple has been the dominant team on the road, the more physical team. They're up 9.
Bit of a surprise here if you're just joining us, a 9-point lead for the Temple Owls. But Cincinnati trying to make things happen near the end of the half. Tim?
Well, that was a big bucket by Cumberland. You can start to feel the momentum going, and then Devondre Perry buries a, in my eyes, an enormous shot. As talked about, Cincinnati's looking for any spark. This crowd's looking for any spark. The cheerleaders, they're looking for any spark to get involved in this game. Great job by Aaron McKee's team. They've really taken Cincinnati out of what they want to do from an offensive standpoint.
Fans are a bit restless here in Cincinnati. Again, an emotional night, senior night, as Cumberland with the take on the drive. He has 11 but can't finish there.
He's looking for the foul there. Last year, the conference player of the year, that's a shot he finishes. Nobody picks up the ball.
Alane Moore buries another one from downtown. And the three balls keep coming for the Temple Owls here tonight.
Yeah, that's just a breakdown by Cincinnati, and that's not the first time or the second time. That's the third time you leave Alani Moore open. That is what he does. He is a shooter.
Scott with a spin move in the lane, just trying to find some room. Throws it up with the right hand, can't finish. Just rolls off of the rim. Shot clock is off, and Temple can play for the final shot of the half.
You got to think that Aaron McKee's going to get Quinton Rose out there.
We'll step aside quickly. 12-point lead for Temple. They'll have the last shot when we come back. Point lead for the Temple Owls. Alani Moore has been red hot from the outside. He just hit his third three-pointer. And Timmy, you said it, they just left him wide open.
Yeah, it's just unacceptable. I mean, there isn't another player in the American Athletic Conference that has made more threes than number zero. You can't leave him. Really a breakdown by Cincinnati. Now, you gotta think that Rose is gonna be the guy here to make a play.
Here's Scott on the baseline, draws the foul, throws it up, can't finish, but he'll go to the line. And that's not a shot you want to foul on here at the end of the period.
Monty Scott's one of those guys that just falls out of bed and he can get buckets. Sets a huge game this year, 25 against UConn, 22 against SMU. He's a transfer from Kennesaw State. He had some monster games there. He had 33 against Stetson, but he had no points in the first matchup. Great job of figuring out a way to get off a very tough shot. Clock running down, created space, got to the free throw line.
Temple able to increase their lead here with 3.1 to play. Currently on a 7-0 run. Make it 8. Cumberland loses the handle and the ball rolls out of bounds, and it's been that kind of half for the Cincinnati Bearcats on senior night. Anything that could go wrong has gone wrong for the Bearcats. An emotional night for sure. The Bearcats need this win to keep their tournament hopes alive, but right now they trail it 31-17. We'll return with AT&T at the half right after the break. Senior night in Cincinnati not going as planned in what is the final home game for 6 Cincinnati seniors. Right now they find themselves trailing in what is a must-win game for the Bearcats to keep their tournament hopes alive. Wolf can be back courtside. Alex Sobario alongside Tim Doyle. Timmy, whatever can go wrong has gone wrong for the Cincinnati Bearcats tonight. They just can't seem to buy a bucket right now.
Yeah, senior night can sometimes be a dream. Instead, it's been a nightmare for Cincinnati. Jarron Cumberland has played, and I actually think it stunted the team because no one really has an offensive rhythm besides Jarron Cumberland. On the flip side, Temple has made shots, 5 first half threes. You heard Wally Zerbiak there at halftime talk about banging down looks and Alani Moore. No one in the American Athletic Conference makes more threes. You want to think about guarding him because he's gotten some wide open looks. And on the flip side, Temple's made 5 threes. Cincinnati's only made 1, but they've shot 10. 24% from the field in the first half, 7 turnovers, 0 offensive rhythm. And you're down 2 touchdowns, like John Rothstein says, but I actually think they could be down more. You look at the stats. They did not play well, and still a puncher's chance to start the second half.
Yeah, Temple not even known for their three-point shooting in the league this year. Really not known for their offense at all this year, but here they are shooting 5 from downtown. Cincinnati only has 1 in 10 tries.
Now, Temple made 9 threes in the first game against Cincinnati. That first game in Philadelphia was a 1-point game with 3 minutes left. I'll tell you this right now, as a former player, when you go up against that team, because you played them competitive the first time, you really lost 4 straight like Temple has. You have a belief that you can compete. I think they've been more physical. I think they've executed better. Cincinnati's had breakdowns on the defensive end, and that's actually due to not making shots. Coaches don't want to hear that. But when you're missing with time after time again, you just don't play as hard. Your attention to detail isn't as good, and it has not been for Cincinnati.
All right, for both of these teams, what do you want to see from both of these teams here in the first maybe 2 or 3 minutes?
Said through talking.
31-17, Temple on top with the first possession. There's rejection from behind by Cumberland. And here's Rose with the runner. Can't get it to fall. Cumberland with a rebound. Stop on the first possession. Cumberland with the kick out. Adams Woods buries from downtown. And that could be that spark you were talking about in that first half. Now the Bearcats have the first field goal here of the second half, trailing by 11, and then Rose goes up with it.
This is just Jarron Cumberland just being a basketball player, just finding open shooters. They had some good looks, they just didn't make any. 1 of 10 in the first half. Really nice start for John Brannon's group to start the second half.
Good ball fake there from Mormon, goes for the baseline jumper, can't get it to go.
You could feel the swing in momentum. That's really close to happening right now.
Cumberland on the take, trying to go glass. A little bit too strong, fighting for the offensive rebound. There's Vogt on the floor for it. Rejected from behind, Pierre-Louis. They'll stay with the Bearcats.
I love the way Temple is playing. I mean, Cincinnati's known for their grit. They're known for their toughness. I know they have a new coach and they're playing a new style, but Temple is bringing that Philly toughness right now. And they are just matching stride for stride and really bullying Cincinnati at their own game.
Yeah, Coach Aaron McKee told me last week that he wants to see from his teams that Philadelphia grit from his team. Use that word grit. His core values bringing in this year, hard work, teamwork, commitment. There's another rejection from behind from Pierre-Louis.
Oh, what great help by Pierre-Louis. Not the biggest guy on the floor, but knowing where to help out his teammates. Williams was so good last out, he had 30, and not that time.
Dump it in the vote. Double comes, jump hook of the lane is good. Moore with the step back. Fight for the rebound. It stays with Temple. Alane Moore for three. Short this time. Now Cumberland up top going for the elevator ride. And can't get the alley-oop to Trevon Scott. But a whistle blows. It'll stay with the Bearcats.
You can see Cumberland had his head up the whole time. Scott and him made eye contact around half court. Temple has liked the call. Good call by the officials. Now you got to go to the free throw line and make a pay.
Trevon Scott, a 62% free throw shooter on the year. Temple still without a point here in this second half. One of two at the line there for Scott.
We heard Jerry Palm at halftime say that Cincinnati already has four quad three losses. So this is a game they have to have. Did not look impressive in that first half. They've come out with some pep in their step to start the second half.
There's Moore in the corner for three again. Two straight misses from the outside for Moore. After hitting three from downtown in the first half, a loose ball foul will keep it on this end of the floor.
Moore's got some great looks here in the second half. Open looks, good dribble penetration there. I think Cincinnati is fortunate that Moore hasn't buried one of those threes. That's what Temple did in that first half. Every time since he was making a run, we saw Perry bury a big three or Moore repeatedly bury big threes to kind of stop the bleeding.
Rose in the corner, and he hits from downtown. All-time leading scorer in the history of the conference. Passed that mark back in the SMU game. 1,800 career points. It's done on both ends of the floor. Steals leader in the history of the conference, too. There's Williams, spin move, and a baby hook. First points of the game. At 30 the other night against South Florida. New career high for him, but he's been rather quiet today. Ten points in the last game against Temple. Shot missed from the outside from Scott, and a rebound to Vogt, and we get another foul call.
This is just big on small. I think that Cincinnati needs to take advantage of this a little bit more. Too much play with the ball on the perimeter. They're not able to go north and south. Get Keith Williams, who still had that monster effort in some mismatches. I would even put Cumberland in the post and have him play out of the post because he's such a great passer. There he is right there. Give him the ball.
Williams. They do get it into Cumberland. Finds a little bit of room. Throws up a little runner. Can't get it to go.
Hey, you could just see there's no explosion there, right, Alex?
Yeah, I mean, that you could tell the heel's been bothering him. And you said, they told us in shoot-around today that you can tell when he goes up or when he gets fouled, that when he lands, that there's not that elevation that we're used to seeing. We'll step aside here after the foul. Cincinnati trailing 34-25 here on Senior Night. Bit of a surprise going on here in Cincinnati. Bearcats outscoring Temple 8-3 in the second half, but trailing by 9 here on Senior Night. And you can see, according to Jerry Palm, right now Cincinnati probably the last team out of those first four out. They're definitely out of the tournament if they don't come up with a comeback victory here against Temple.
Well said. And Jerry Palm is the numbers guru at the CBS. And those are the other opportunities left to get quality wins, whether it's Houston or Tulsa. You're running out of chances. And when you heard Jerry Palm at halftime say 4 quad 3 losses, and John Brandon, who came here and really adapted a new system. Right. Nick Cronin was more of a half-court, grinded-out zone type of guy. Brandon, with players and guys like Cumberland, the reigning player of the year, he wants to play a different style. He wants to go fast. He wants to go up and down. And he's kind of had to adjust his style towards his personnel. Tell you this right now, 17 first half points, and that's not the pace he wants to be playing.
Yeah, he's changed everything. He's even changed the way they approach pregame meals and things of that sort. And he says, we're still not playing the way that we want to down the road. He kind of had to acquiesce a little bit to some of the senior leadership here to try to play a style that was a little more balanced to what they were used to, but still moving towards the way he wants to down the road. Here's Cumberland, finds some room for the three. Misses off the back iron.
Now 2 of 13 from three, Cincinnati is.
This is Parks, now to Moore with a baseline J. He misses. Now here come the Bearcats. Desperate for a bucket. Cumberland to the rim, count the basket on the foul.
I just love the guts that the senior is playing with. Missed last game. He was in a booth on the bench during their last game against USF. You can see he was not moving at 100% at shoot-around. He has been moving at 100% in this game, and he is just trying to will his team back in it.
14 of their 28 points. See if Temple can respond. Temple just 14 wins on the season. This is Rose. Pierre-Louis to the rim. Can't get it to go, but the putback on the opposite side of the bucket is Parks. Ten-point game. Another drive. No offensive foul this time. Called against Williams.
You can see the officials having a conversation. Was he outside? I don't think he was, Alex. I think he was still moving inside of that arc. See that left foot?
And that left foot was still in the arc. Referees talked about it. Fans don't like it. John Brannon doesn't like it. But that's the type of night it's been for Cincinnati. That's a big swing. When you're struggling to score, and the referees, I don't want to say take away a three-point opportunity, but they took away a three-point opportunity with a missed call.
Six on the shot clock. Here's Rose from long range with a hand in his face. It goes back the other way. Loose ball foul against Temple. It's going to be against Perry.
That ball was straight on, just a bit long, and then you see the overzealous Perry there. Tensions are starting to run high. Crowd is into it. Coaches are into it. And I actually think Temple should be up by more points. Now they left this door open for back-to-back buckets, and they're going to excite a crowd that's definitely wanted to cheer in this game. Haven't had a lot to cheer about.
Cumberland on the take this time. Draws contact again, and he'll go back to the line. Nearly finished another one there.
I don't know if he finished that one. This is like, I call this the 45-year-old dentist drive to the basket. You just put your head down and you just say, I'm going to get some contact here. Like, it wasn't pretty, but he gets to the free throw line and he is just trying to gut this team out. I just love the energy he's playing with. And no, I am not a dentist, okay? But I have a body like a 45-year-old.
All right, speaking of dentists, coming up next, we wrap up the regular season in the NCHC as Colorado College takes on sixth-ranked Denver in an in-state showdown, only on CBS Sports Network. A little college hockey for you.
Ben Holden on the call there, great hockey voice.
Things continue to go against Cincinnati's way tonight here on Senior Night.
Yeah, I mean, the scoring has been like pulling teeth in this one for sure.
This is Moore. Still looking for a bucket here in the second half. Rose with seven on the shot clock. And a crossover Scott gets to the rim. Reverse layup. Beautiful move there from Quentin Rose.
It's the shoes, Alex. The shoes. He's the only player on the floor that has one pink and one blue shoe.
Here's Vogt underneath, can't get that one. It was from point blank range and Vogt just couldn't finish.
So this is NBA ball here. This is Aaron McKee saying, let's give Rose the ball and let him make something happen. He gets the mismatch he wants.
Look at the shot clock down just about every possession now. Here's Rose to the rim again. Incredible floater, couldn't get it.
Digest this, okay? Nobody in the history of this conference has scored more points than that guy. Now, I know it's a fairly new conference, but still, no one scored more points than him, and he's just one of those guys that just gets buckets. He had 26 in the first matchup, a close loss to Cincinnati.
Ball knocked out of the hands. They were trying to get it to Rose and stay with Temple.
You know, I try to project at this point, you know, a final score. And you got to think, if Temple gets to 60, they're going to be in pretty good shape here.
Shot clock expires, just couldn't get one off in time.
And I'm sure if you're a Cincinnati fan, it feels eerily similar. You're down 11, but you're at home. Last out, they were down 13 with 13 minutes left. No Jarron Cumberland, but this crowd's been wanting to cheer in this game.
Talking about Temple and their scoring. They are 13-6 this year when they score 65 or more. 65 may be the magic number for them. 3-point attempt, top of the key. Trevon Cumberland hits from downtown. Rose. goes, drawing the contact as he goes to the bucket. He's got two coming up.
Cincinnati has been fighting. They've been clawing. And their leader, Jarron Cumberland and his cousin, trying to bring their squad back in this one. They need this win. It means a lot. But they're down 8 at home.
Well, let's see who the toughest on the court is, brought to you by Gorilla Glue. It's been Jarron Cumberland for the Bearcats.
Not at 100%, but toughing it out on his senior night and trying to will his team back in the game. They have not been at their best from an offensive standpoint. Better in the second half, but still down 8.
We'll see who the toughest is in the Patriot League tomorrow, starting at noon Eastern in the Patriot League semifinals. Find out which team will advance to the championship only on CBS Sports Network. Seeds 1, 5, 3, and 7 in Patriot League action. That's tomorrow. Championship game coming up on Wednesday.
And the number 2 seed American got bounced, so you got to think that's going to open it up to Colgate. Their outstanding squad last year gave Tennessee all they could handle. And Jerry Palm, you know, fiddling around 15 seed, 14 seed. I'll say this, an experienced team that can shoot the 3 is going to be very dangerous in the tournament. That Colgate team knocked off this Cincinnati team earlier this year.
And there's a lot of movement just happening today all the way around as Rose hits the free throw line. Utah State just beat San Diego State. So that takes away a potential bid because Utah State might have been the last 4 in. You don't know. And then, of course, what's going on in the Missouri Valley, just wackiness going on in Arch Madness.
Northern Iowa, in my eyes, deserved an at-large, but they got bounced by Drake, Loyola Chicago. They blew an 18-point second-half lead to Valpo. I covered that conference this year. That was a really good conference. I think it's a shame they're only going to get one bid, but that's what they're going to end up with.
Well, that makes things even tougher as we're going to drive to the bucket from Adams Woods, and he'll go to the line as he draws the foul. For teams like in the American, the Wichita States and the Cincinnati's of the world, to get into the tournament.
Yeah, and now you got to go out there and you got to find wins. See, when you're in a Power 5, right, you're going to have those other opportunities in the conference tournament. I think there's nothing harder to handicap than a conference tournament because some teams are locked in, some teams are all in because that's their last shot, and then some teams are already looking about at the big tournament, the NCAA. So it's hard to tell where a team's head is at. I know when I was at Northwestern, I was thinking about spring break a lot because we didn't make too many tournaments. 0, that is.
Adams Woods can't finish from the foul line there. Temple still holding on to a double-digit lead here in the Cincinnati Bearcats on their senior night. A game that is a must-win for Cincinnati. We won't have any hopes of an at-large bid into the tournament. Two on the shot clock, they gotta hurry. Moore gets it off just in the nick of time. And the official sending the teams to their bench.
And Phil Jacobson right on top of that. He's gonna sit basket, he's good on the floor. And I don't think it is good.
So you can
take a look at the clock. You can hear official coming over to let us know. They say on the floor it is a made basket, but they're going to take a look.
In a game where every basket is so important, the referee's got that one right. They're gonna wave that one off.
A sigh of relief from this Cincinnati crowd who kind of think that everything is going against them right now. Not necessarily by the officials, but just in fate-wise.
I mean, there's a lot of time in this game. Aaron McKee knows that. I mean, this team has been up for the challenge. They've always seemed to make a key 3 when Cincinnati has made those runs.
Cumberland Cousins passing him back and forth up at the top. Over to Scott.
2-3 zone for Temple.
This is Javen Cumberland here to Jarron. Rating player of the year, a little runner, can't get it. Now here's Temple in transition to Alani Moore.
I know what Temple's going to try to do. They're going to try to shorten the game, but now with a shorter shot clock, I think it's harder to do. He's still going to keep playing.
Bump it underneath, and Moore. Damian Moore puts that one in the center from Jackson, Mississippi. Wearing number 44 this year. He switched his uniform number in the offseason from 23 to 44 to honor LSU forward Wade Sims, who was killed September of last year. Played together. AAU ball down in the south.
That's really good execution there. Great passing. Ward's been good in this game.
Yeah.
Some nice catches and finishes. Easy. A lot of big guys make it complicated. Now Volk goes to the line where, let's just say, it's been a challenge for him. And the form, a bit unorthodox, really off to the side the way he shoots it.
Volk just with 2 points today. He is able to connect there. And Cincinnati's, this crowd, they're not used to cheering kind of free throws the way they're cheering free throws right now, but every point matters. And this is a team that they score 72 plus a game. They shoot better than 45%. They've got the best field goal percentage and scoring margin in the conference. And they've got 34 points here with 10 minutes to go in the game.
That's a lot of time. Lots of time left. That's why for Temple, you got to keep playing and being aggressive. You can't salt this game away with 10 minutes left. As for Cincinnati, John Brennan trying to extend pressure to get maybe some offense from their defense.
Rose and Moore. Scott falling out of bounds, trying to bounce it off of Williams, and they say no. Out of bounds off of Scott.
This is the first possession that Cincinnati had showed 1-3-1. You get the ball in a bad spot, and then right there, you're out of bounds, ball hits you, easy call.
So Cincinnati looking to cut it to single digits as Cumberland drives. Way off balance on that shot. Still fighting for the rebound, it goes out of play. Last touch, Temple.
I mean, it's pretty simple if you're Cincinnati, right? Someone else is going to make a shot. Whether it's Javon Cumberland or Keith Williams, Trevon Scott, someone else is going to help out Jarron right now because he's trying to do a little bit too much on the offensive end.
Scott. Through traffic. Wow, what a play into Keith Williams. Just found enough room to get the lay-in with the left hand. Temple lead down to 8. Scott in the corner for 3, buries it. And every single time that the crowd gets amped up here at Fifth Third Arena, as Javon Cumberland tries to respond, and he's fouled on a 3 by Alani Moore.
I mean, this is just an outstanding extra pass by Alani Moore. He could have shot this ball right there. Instead, great decision. Could have gotten a good shot. Gets a better shot from Monty Scott. That is just outstanding execution against the 1-3-1 zone. A lot of guys that shoot that ball, especially Alani Moore. He's made some threes, made 3 in the first half, made the extra pass, helped out his teammate, and Scott only shooting 26% on the year from 3. Buries a big one.
Scott's a guy that's used to playing kind of bigger minutes. He's a transfer from Kennesaw State. Obviously bigger minutes, more important minutes there. Third in the Atlantic Sun his sophomore season, over 17 a game. Obviously a much different role when you transfer up into the American Athletic Conference.
They're standing at 1-3-1 with Diarra up top.
Scott to the rim this time, gets it to go, counted in the foul.
And this is all set up by 5'10 senior point guard Alani Moore. Last time made the extra pass. Then on that possession, he's able to get into the teeth of the defense, get everyone rotated so that when Scott has the ball, he already has an edge, and he's able to finish and get to the line.
A little tiptoe down that baseline to get the layup. Completes the three-point play. And the lead back to 11 for the Owls.
I think this is going to have to be the guy right there, number two in red. Keith Williams had a tough finish before. He's going to need to be aggressive for the goodness of his team.
Williams with it now. Dump it off down low. Good pass. Got it into Diarra. We'll cut it back to nine.
Back to man-to-man. Great execution by Temple against that 1-3-1 zone. They really got great looks.
Go with the high screen and roll set by Damian Moore. This is Alani Moore trying to find some freedom. Off balance shot, can't get it. Too high off of the glass. This is Cumberland. Deflected, taken away. Here's Rose in transition. Takes it to the rim for the flush.
You don't become the all-time steals leader in the history of the conference without reading some passing lanes. That time read it perfectly.
Got it down low, and that's a beautiful rejection, but it stays with Cincinnati. Scott down low into Williams, and he finishes. Keith Williams, a former All-New York City High School Player of the Year. Been in double figures 19 times this season. Reach-in foul called against Cumberland.
Quentin Rose, nobody has more points, nobody has more steals in the history of the American. And on a big possession, comes up with a huge steal. Temple, all game long, and they're trying to go wire to wire. You're watching Bracket Week presented by Kubota.
Temple trying to play the role of spoiler, but Jarron Cumberland trying to will his team to victory. 15 points in the game, and they've been hard to come by for him with this Temple defense. 52-43, Temple on top. Cumberland, who was in a boot on Tuesday at South Florida in Tampa, in the starting lineup today. And the points have been tough, Timmy, but he's doing his best.
It just seems like every time Cincinnati has made a run, Temple has had an answer, either with a drive or a big three.
Here's Scott from long range, and he's going to get called for an offensive foul for extending the leg on the three-point attempt.
You know, I was never much of a shooter, but I never shot the ball and thought, I'm going to kick out my leg at the same time. I was just really trying to just make the shot.
I just had enough trouble getting up in the air.
Temple's been in this zone. I would try to get Cumberland right into that middle spot, right there. It's the soft spot.
David Cumberland for three. Hit a big one earlier, missed there. Ball tapped out of bounds, and it's going to stay with Cincinnati.
Now here's why I put Jarron Cumberland there, because he's such a great passer. Get him the ball in the middle. Let him make a play, either turn around, shoot that jumper. Him being out top, I'm not sure he's best suited out there.
Cumberland, Jarron, outside, Williams for three, rattles one home. Six-point game. Pierre Louis on the take. Rejected. Diarra with the defensive play. Here's Cumberland to Javen for three.
Cumberland to Cumberland, senior to senior, Cincinnati, they have to be all in. This game is must win, and they're clawing back. Come on back.
College basketball on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Kubota. Together we do more. By Rogue, don't weaken. And by Gorilla, for the toughest jobs on planet Earth.
One of the greatest Bearcats of all time, one of the greatest basketball players, period, of all time. The big O, Oscar Robertson, honored outside Fifth Third Bank Arena here in Cincinnati. His number 12 hangs up in the rafters here in Cincinnati. 33 points per game, third all-time in NCAA history. One of the more sensational careers in basketball history.
And my dad played for the Pistons when he played for the Cincinnati Royals. And in the preseason, they would drive around to Michigan and Ohio, and the two teams would travel together. So Oscar was one of the greats of all time, even better guy off the floor.
It's a three-point game. It's been a double-digit lead for a good chunk of time for Temple, and they respond as J.P. Mormon hits the jumper. How big is that for Temple right now?
I mean, what a pass by Mormon, and then just come back and bury the jump shot. I'm not sure that's what Aaron McKee drew up in the huddle, but it looked good.
That ends the 8-0 run of the Cincinnati Bearcats that cut it to three. What's been working this last couple of minutes for Cincinnati?
It's been Cumberland and more Cumberland.
Here's Diarra from the outside, buries the triple. Diarra's got nine. New season high for him. Rose, trying to draw the contact, misses. Mormon with a rebound.
Diarra can make that shot. He's 7 of 11 from three, so he shot that one with confidence.
Barely. To Moore. Back to Mormon. Two on the shot clock. Got to hurry. Fall away at the horn. Doesn't hit anything. Shot clock violation.
It was Cumberland getting into the lane, and then Diarra, I talked about, missed a three earlier in this game, but steps up and buries that. He shot 11 threes in his career. He's made seven of them. Can I give you some more advice, kid? Shoot some more threes.
Cincinnati can tie or take the lead in this possession. Diarra, blocking foul underneath, called against Parks. It's a two-point game. It's starting to rock here in Cincinnati on senior night. They need this win desperately. Stay with us. Tomorrow at 4 Eastern, we have more American Athletic Conference action as Tulsa heads out to battle Wichita State, only on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. We take a look at what's going on in the AAC. We have another game on CBS as well. Houston taking on Memphis. Tulsa trying to hang on to their spot up at the top of the conference. They could be the number one seed in next week's conference tournament.
A huge game for Wichita State. Jerry Palm has them on the outside looking in. Still a chances to get quality wins in conference before the conference tournament begins, but Cincinnati was not at its best in the first half when they had 17 points, 6-25 from the field. But they got a shot right now with two made free throws to tie this game up.
And Diarra in this game has nine, which ties his career high. He can break it right now here at the foul line. He's in double figures for the first time in his career. And Cincinnati has needed someone to step up. And it's Mamadou Diarra. Can tie it here. One-point lead for Temple.
I'd get the ball in Alani Moore's hands. Let him be the playmaker.
Here's Moore in on David Cumberland to the rim. Blocked on the way up. Jarron Cumberland on the break. Dishes it off. Williams puts it up, puts it in. First lead of the game for the Bearcats. Trying to respond, and he does as he hits the triple, gets the lead right back for the Owls.
Oh, big time shot there for the junior from Baltimore. Shot up with confidence as the wheels were coming off. They needed something to stop the bleeding, and Perry stepped up.
Perry's got eight. Williams, step back three. High rebound. Pierre-Louis goes up with it. Two-point lead for Temple. They've got the basketball. Rose lets it fly, partially blocked by Williams. Cincinnati again. Cumberland will slow down. Stop for the three! Out in front. In transition, Perry to the rim. Slams it home. And Temple responds to reclaim the lead.
We're going back and forth. Nice job there by Keith Williams. Get a hand on the ball. And Jarron Cumberland goes, I ain't going out like that. Buries the three to give them the lead. But then a complete blown assignment on the other end. I mean, they just lost Devondre Perry, he went in for the easy dunk. That's not the first time that's happened. That's not the fifth time that has happened. They've lost shooters, and that was a key moment there. Temple grabs back the lead.
How do you like the way Temple has responded these last few trips down the floor when Cincinnati taking the lead?
They've had answers all game long, and that's why they have a one-point lead. Come on back. Cincinnati needs this win, and they're down one.
Well, it was a sloppy game early, but it's starting to build intensity-wise. And you look at a flush like that from Devondre Perry. A rim rocker to give Temple the lead one more time.
Yeah, he's had multiple answers. That time a blown assignment by Cincinnati, but a few possessions ago he buried a big three. Aaron McKee's bunch, they've lost four straight, but they've been really, really tough. We talked about them being Philly tough. Well, they've showed that in this one.
Perry now in double figures with 10. He did not play the last time these two teams faced each other in Philly. He's dealing with a toe injury then. Here's Cumberland. Dishes off and a foul as Diarra went up with it.
They got Jarron Cumberland with an ability off a drift screen, fade screen, flare, whatever you want to call it, but the ability to turn the corner, and then once the defense came, he made the right basketball decision, and Diarra was good in the first half. He's been better in the second half. He's been an X factor in this game.
It's been guys outside the star players you would expect that have been contributing here in the second half. Diarra for Cincinnati. Just tied the game here at 59. And guys like Monty Scott, Devondre Perry for Temple. Cincinnati needing this win to stay alive. It would be their 10th consecutive 20-win season as well. 10 straight appearances in the NCAA tournament if they can get in, but they gotta get in first. And it starts with winning this one here. Timeout, Temple. Cincinnati reclaims the lead again. They lead by one with 90 seconds to go. Back in Cincy, the Bearcats reclaiming the lead here by one. With just 90 seconds to play. Timmy, how do you want to see Temple respond here?
Well, they have the all-time leading scorer in the history of the American Athletic Conference. You got to think it's going to be Quentin Rose, either coming off a down screen or getting a high ball screen. And he's been quiet the last couple of minutes, like you talked about. It's been the Scotts of the world, the Perrys of the world. I thought Alani Moore's made a lot of great basketball decisions. But now, minute 30 left, you're on the road. This is big boy time. This is big boy opportunity. You got a guy that's got a lot of big boy buckets. Quentin Rose has to be your guy.
Cincinnati has had the lead for just 30 seconds of game time. This is a game. It had so much emotion going into it. We knew it was senior night, but when you talk about head coach John Brennan, the service for his late father who passed away a week ago today is coming up. You have to know that he's thinking about that because his father, John, was his biggest fan, was at all the games when he could make it, both at his games and his brother's games. His brother Grant, coach Ed Walton of Verona High, had to step away from that job to care for his ailing father. You can bet head coach John Brennan thinking about that as this game comes towards its end.
His team has showed a lot of stick-to-itiveness in this one because it has not been pretty. They had 17 points at halftime, but Jarron Cumberland has put this team on his shoulders, and they have a one-point lead. And you're gonna see timeout here by Brandon. He didn't like the setup. He's not happy with his squad.
He takes a timeout. So we'll take it with him. One-point lead for the Bearcats here in Cincinnati. For those of you tuning in for the Colorado College Denver hockey game, you'll be able to find that online, cbssports.com/CBSSN, as soon as it begins. And of course, we'll get you out there immediately after the conclusion of this game. Temple now trailing by one after leading for a majority of the contest as Rose drives to the rim and he's hauled down to the floor.
That's who you wanted to have the ball in his hands. And Keith Williams is one of the better defenders, not just in this conference, but all of college basketball. And he kind of forced that contact. A lot of ball in that play, though. But Rose is able to get to the free throw line. Love that call out of a timeout by Aaron McKee.
So Quentin Rose, 79% free throw shooter with the miss there. He can tie it with a make here.
I've been on the free throw lines with the fat heads in there and the fans going crazy. But these are the moments you want to be in if you're another team's best player. Now, there's no pressure here. This is the spot you want to be in if you're Rose.
That was the first missed free throw of the game for Temple. Connects on the second. We're tied at 60. 120 to play. What kind of action are you looking for here from Cincinnati?
It's going to be Cumberland making a play.
Cumberland spin move in the lane, throws one up for the window and in. Cincy back out in front. Carrying his team on his back on senior night. Here's Rose on the other end. He tried to go glass. He misses. And Cumberland right there for the rebound. Here come the Bearcats. 3-on-2. Cumberland with a dish and a deflection out of play.
This is just Jarron Cumberland, not at 100%. Just going all out, laying it all out on the floor here. His last game on his home floor, flexing the muscles, coming up big. And his team has trailed throughout, and he has just put this squad on his back on his senior night. Now, if you got a layup, obviously that's what they're trying to do. Now you got to pull it back. You got to work clock here if you're Cincinnati. And that's the guy I want. With the ball in his hands, John Brennan's going to get a timeout. He wants to draw up something specific for this spot.
Last timeout for the Bearcats. They take it here. Stay with us. Two-point game. 42:6 to play here in Cincinnati. And Cumberland taking over here in the final moments.
Yeah, well, it felt like when Temple was up 8, they should have been up 15. When they were up 12, they should have been up 20. They never took advantage of that opportunity, and they left the door open. And you could just feel Cincinnati had that run in them. Jarron Cumberland is not at 100%. He didn't play in the last game. But this is his senior night, and so many times, Alex, we see on senior nights kind of having those out-of-body experiences. I had one when I played at Northwestern against Indiana. Cumberland's having one tonight, potentially his last home game at Fifth Third.
And he's getting contributions from Williams and Diarra here in the second half. They've needed other people to respond because he has not been able to give everything that he can when he's healthy.
You know what he did? He kept them afloat, though. You know, he did as much as he could. Then you're right, Williams, Diarra. And now it's going to be Cumberland now. Look for him to come high. And then when he comes high, I think it's going to be him, Trevon Scott playing two-man basketball.
Here's Keith Williams to Cumberland back up top.
Mismatch.
Not on the shot clock. Waves off the screen. Cumberland takes the three. No. Into the hands of Alani Moore. Temple still has a timeout. Here's Perry. Outside. Mormon buries the triple from the outside. Clutch three. Temple back out in front. No timeouts left for Cincinnati. Cumberland to the rim. No, the tip is good. Trevon Scott, 1 second, lets it fly. Rose, no. Cincinnati escapes.
Big time shot on the road. J.P. Mormon, he put his team up. But then Cumberland, the pressure on the defense, got three black shirts around. Nobody boxed out Scott. The tip in. But it was really the aggressiveness of Cumberland. Watch it, everyone ran towards him. Nobody boxed out. And that happens so often. It's not the first shot, it's the rebound. And this was not a pretty game, a game where Cincinnati had 17 points at halftime, but they found a way. And after taking that lead, Rose's shot a bit short. Temple showed a lot of guts on the road after losing four straight, but Cincinnati comes away with the enormous home win, and they keep their NCAA hopes alive.
And they keep their hopes alive from getting that one seed in the conference tournament with their 13th win. Tulsa has a game tomorrow, as does Houston. That was Scott's 12th rebound, and it ended up being a putback that would put them out in front. Up next, it's college hockey. Colorado College taking on 6th-ranked Denver. For Tim Doyle and our entire crew, my name's Alex Sobario. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. 20 wins now for the Bearcats. Thanks for joining us.